गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे इज़ द फोर्थ पार्ट ऑफ चैप्टर हाउ डू ऑर्गेनिज्म रिप्रोड्यूस। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। फर्स्ट टॉपिक इज सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन एंड वेरिएशन। व्हाट इज सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन? सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन इज अ प्रोसेस बाय विच टू पेरेंट्स प्रोड्यूस गैमीट एंड बाय द फ्यूजन ऑफ मेल एंड फीमेल गैमीट इट विल लीड टू फॉर्मेशन ऑफ यंग वन और इट विल लीड टू फॉर्मेशन ऑफ ऑफस्प्रिंग्स। सो in sexual reproduction two parents are involved and gamete formation and gamete fusion is there. What are gametes? Gametes are the special cells which are formed after meiosis. And meiosis is the reductional division. There are two type of gamete, male gamete and female gamete, and the number of chromosome in gamete is half that of individual, means it is haploid in state. And when this gamete fuse, means when male female gamete fuse, the process is known as fertilization, and this will lead to maintaining the chromosome number equal, means the chromosome become diploid in zygote. So in sexual reproduction there is a process that will help for maintaining the chromosome number in young one also with the help of meiosis, and after meiosis the fusion of male and female gamete get take place, and it will lead to formation of zygote and young one, and this contain the same number of chromosome. Next, in sexual reproduction the offspring get sets of gene from two different individual, means in sexual reproduction the young one, the offspring will get the genes from both the parents, means from male and female also. So here it is written that in sexual reproduction the offspring get sets of genes, or you can say sets of DNA from the two different individuals. This lead to formation of some type of variation, and this variation will accumulate from one generation to next generation, and it will continue from generation to generation, and this variation will lead to formation of a new species or a new organism. This process is similar as that of evolution of man from ape like ancestor. Now what is DNA replication? Replication is a process, or simply we can write down, replication is a photocopying mechanism. And what is DNA? DNA is the genetic material, and DNA is the genetic material of an organism. In human, DNA is transferred from one generation to next generation via gametes, that is male and female gametes. So during formation of gamete, the DNA replication take place, means the DNA form exact copy, and this copy will transfer from gametes to next generation. So DNA replication is a process by which DNA make a copy of itself, or by which a DNA make a copy of DNA. DNA replication occur during S phase. S phase is the phase present in cell cycle. What is cell cycle? When the cell mature, cell divide, then cell again mature, and then cell again divide. These are the some cyclic event that take place during the maturation and division, and it is known as cell cycle. So in cell cycle there is a phase known as S phase or synthesis phase. As the name suggests, synthesis. So in this S phase, DNA replication, DNA synthesis take place. Why DNA synthesis or DNA replication is used or is important? Because the daughter will have the exact additional copy of DNA as that of parent. So DNA replication help for transferring the exact copy of DNA from parents to offspring. And next, sometime during replication there is alteration may be there, means sometime DNA content get changed, and this DNA content, if DNA content get changed, then it will lead to form a variation. Variation is degree of difference between parents and its next generation. Now sexual reproduction in flowering plants. In the previous part, second, third, there is asexual reproduction in plants and known as vegetative propagation. Here, sexual reproduction in flowering plant is discussed here. And what is flower? Flower is the modified structure. Flower is the modified structure. And flower contain all the organs that are required for sexual reproduction or that are required for maintaining the reproductive system. A typical flower is composed of four distinct whorl, calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium. A typical flower is consist of or composed of four different structure, calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium. Now what is calyx, what is corolla, what is androecium and what is gynoecium? So let's start. Suppose when we hold a flower, the outermost structure is generally green in color, means outermost leaf like structure is present, and this leaf like structure is green in color, and this structure is known as calyx. So calyx is the outermost whorl of flower. Calyx is the outermost whorl of flower, and it is composed of green leaf like structure. And another name of calyx is sepals. Other name of calyx is sepals. Now second, corolla. Corolla is inner to sepal, and this is the second leaf like structure of flower. It is composed of colorful leaf like structure called as petal. Petals are colorful so that insects and birds can be attracted. Petals are colorful so that insects and birds can be attracted. When we hold you can say a rose flower, rose contain red color leaf like structure. Rose has red leaf. So this red color leaf like structure is corolla, or you can say petals. So petals are generally bright color structure, bright color leaf like structure, and this petal will help for attracting the insects and birds. And birds and insects are attracted with the help of petals. So why birds and insects are attracted towards flower? A pollination is a process by which male gamete of flower is transferred to female portion. We will discuss this in later. Next is androecium. Androecium is the third leaf like structure, or you can say third whorl in the flower. It is composed of stamen. Androecium is composed of stamen. Stamen is made up of slender stalk and anther on the top. Means stamen is stamen contain anther and filament. Stamen contain anther and filament. And in anther, pollen grains are produced. In anther, pollen grains are produced. What is pollen grain? Pollen grains are mainly male gametes. Pollen grains are male gamete. Next, gynoecium. Gynoecium is the structure which is present in the center of flower. It is composed of swollen area known as ovary, a slender style, and it has a flat top called as stigma. Means gynoecium contains stigma, style and ovary, and inside ovary ovules are present, and ovules are female gametes. Yes, you can see this labeling. You can see the outermost green color leaf are known as sepals. The lowermost portion you can see here. Sepals is given in labeling. The lowermost portion. And then you can see red color leaf like structure is there. These are some petal. These are some petals, not pistil. Outermost green leaf like structure is sepal, then red color structure is petals. Petals help for attracting the insect. Petal help for attracting the insect, and by insect pollination take place. Then you can see anther and filament. Filament is a thread like structure which hold the anther. So anther is the site of pollen grain production. Anther is the site of pollen grain production. And pollen grains are male gamete, and filament hold the anther only. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 anthers and filament structure is there in the figure. then you can see the female part, that is stigma, style and ovary. Stigma is the landing platform for pollen grain. Style is a long tube-like structure. Style is a long tube-like structure that is connected with the ovary. And ovary contain ovule. You can see the in labeling, wall of ovary and ovary contain ovule. And this ovule this ovule is a female gamete. And pollen grain from anther is transferred to the stigma part, and through stigma the male gamete will travel towards the female gamete in ovule area. Now this is pollination. Simply we have to write this. Pollination is a process by which pollen grains are transferred from stigma. Pollen grains are transferred to the stigma. I am again repeating. Pollen grains are transferred from anther to stigma so that fertilization, sexual reproduction may take place. The transfer of pollen grain from anther to stigma is called as pollination. And pollination is of two types, self-pollination and cross-pollination. Suppose pollen grain is transferred from same flower to the same stigma. If the pollen grains are transferred from same flower to the same stigma, same flower stigma, then it is known as self-pollination. If pollen grain from different plants are transferred to the stigma, then it is known as cross-pollination. As the name suggests, self means a flower contain anther and filament, a flower contains stigma style ovary. So when this pollen grains are transferred from anther to stigma, then it is known as self-pollination. And when the pollen grains are transferred from one flower to next flower, then it is known as cross-pollination. So cross-pollination is a better prospective. Why cross-pollination is preferable? Because in this, the pollen grain from one plant is transferred to the different plant, so that when two different plant gametes get fused, then it will lead to formation of variation. So how cross-pollination will take place? Means the distance between the plants may be more or less depending upon situation. So how cross-pollination favors? So for transferring the pollen grain from one plant to the different plant, many agents are there, natural agents are there, which transfer the pollen grain, that is insects, animals, air and water. By the air, means when the air flow, the pollen grain may be dispersed. The pollen grain may be dispersed from the air current from anther to stigma. And from if the plant lie in water area or water bodies, then water will transfer the pollen grain, and some insects may be help for the transfer of pollen grain from anther to the stigma, depending upon different conditions of plant and depending upon different sources. And mainly insects are the main pollinators. Pollinators are the agents that help for the transfer of pollen grain. So insects are the main pollinator for plant kingdom. Yes, this is all about in today's lecture. Thank you.